Hello students, today in this class we are going to discuss Chipko movement and Silent Valley movement. So first of all, let us start with Chipko movement. So Chipko movement, it is primarily a forest conservation movement. So this movement, it occurred in the Uttarakhand district. Now when the movement occurred, Uttarakhand was a part of Uttar Pradesh. So it occurred in 1970s. So it is a forest conservation movement where the people, they protested against the illegal felling of trees by the forest department of Uttarakhand or Uttar Pradesh through a non-violence movement. They hugged the trees, embraced the trees and protested against the felling of the trees. So it was a mass movement. It inspired many eco groups, NGOs, many communities. It inspired them, and the rapid rate of deforestation was slowed down. So it moved the eye of the society towards the deforestation problems, and it is an opener in the field of environmental movement, we can say. So many movements were inspired by the Chipko movement. In 1987, the Chipko movement was awarded the Right Livelihood Award for its dedication to the conservation, restoration and ecologically sound use of their landmass and natural resources. So this movement, it got the Right Livelihood Award for their contribution and conservation of the environment in which they were living. Now, Chipko movement in India. So Chipko movement started in 1970s, as I said, in the Uttarakhand district, which was then part of Uttar Pradesh only. So this movement started in the northern Himalayan segment, that is on the foothills of the Himalayas. So the word Chipko means to hug or to stick. The name came from what meaning to embrace. So in India, many leaders like Sundarlal Bahuguna, Gaura Devi, Chandi Prasad Bhatt, they came forward as a leader, they participated and they leaded the Chipko movement. So basically, why the people protested, because the rapid distribution, deforestation was leading them to some major problems. The problems were like, they were not getting their firewood, their underground water for drinking was becoming less day by day. So mainly the women community were affected by these problems, because women had to run their household. So women were mainly affected by this rapid deforestation. So the women, although there were many men who took part in the Chipko movement, but the women were the main leaders of the Chipko movement. So it is basically a eco-feminism movement. Sometimes we call it as eco-feminism movement. Now, causes was that the large-scale deforestation, of course, it brought a lot of hardship to common people. Then government was also not paying attention to their problems. The poor people, they have to depend on the natural resources for their livelihood. But the government was not paying any attention to them. So the people themselves, they took the lead and protested. They did a non-violence protest against the rapid deforestation in their area. And because of deforestation, the land condition was degrading. They were not getting enough water and they were suffering from malnutrition. So they were suffering from all this sort of problem. That is why they went for Chipko movement. Now coming to the history, from where the idea of Chipko movement has come. See, the idea of Chipko movement, it comes from 1730 AD, when there was a village in Rajasthan called Prasanna Khamkar. So in 1730 AD, what happened? Maharaja Bhuvan Singh, he ordered his soldiers to bring some wood by cutting the khejri trees. So in Rajasthan, the khejri trees are very famous. They are very known the population of khejri trees is maximum in Rajasthan. So the Maharaja ordered the soldiers to cut down the khejri trees and bring wood to be used in the palace. Now the Vishnois community, there is a community in Rajasthan called Vishnoi community. This community, generally they respect the nature very, they most humbly, they respect the nature, plants and animals around them. So they protested against the deforestation of the khejri trees, which is also known as ghaf tree, that is a national tree of Saudi Arabia. So they protested against the cutting down of the khejri trees, and most of them, almost 363 people of the Vishnoi community, they died by protesting against the rapid deforestation. So from this, the idea of the Chipko movement has come. And in 1987, Chipko movement got the Right Livelihood Award for their conservation, for their protest against the deforestation, and for utilizing the natural resources sustainably. So this is about the Chipko movement.